open the door.
Door wasn't closed.
Oh, right. Okay. So yeah, like, okay, look, you have four laps. Last two, I'm gonna time, if you don't mind, I recommend that.
Yeah.
First two, you get used to it, understand what's up.
Yeah.
Because it's a very different condition, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Don't launch it. Anything, we're not competing. So I move, even when I'm timing you, move off the line like you're doing at a stop line with a cop next to you. I'm gonna start the clock after the car is moving.
So just
normal.
Yeah.
Yeah, like that. And that's when I'll start.
On my car, I have to raise the revs. Like my clutch is very bad. I haven't gotten used to that.
Thank you. quite tough to do four laps. Then you could break the axle. I have broken an axle like this. So you want to always straighten the car and drive for a few minutes for the diffs everything to line up.
Okay.
This is a tip for you, right? Okay, wait, no, not going nowhere. So now we're gonna do the two time lapse. I want you to concentrate on not making mistakes, and this is just to give you a taste of doing a good job but not overdoing it under pressure of a watch. Because a lot of people fuck this up. That's why I do it here. And Bolin, let's say he did five laps perfect, sixth lap, first lap I was timing him, he destroyed the pilot.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? So that's why, like, do what you are doing. If you feel confident that that corner is good, push for it. If you feel it's rough, slow down. But just like now that you know you're on the clock, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So whenever you're going to move off slowly, I'm going to start the clock.
Yeah. I'm going to do it, hopefully, with that much. I'm not used to it at all.
That's okay, you know. Let the clutch go, let's talk.
I think I'm going to sort of focus on the
roughness.
Yeah, also the corners that I'm doing well, I think I'm going to just do what I'm doing, but I think I'm going to focus on that muddy bit, okay, trying to get the traction there by staying on a different part of the track than it was.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like when I'm in that mud, I'm losing a lot of the time there. Because
yeah.
I'm not used to that sort of like no traction at all turning and nothing's happening sort of experience with trying to find time on such a loose surface at that. Like even snow and ice, you've got more traction than that sometimes.
Yeah,
so.
Exactly. Okay. Overall, your techniques are good, you know, so yeah. So let's have a clean one. Let's see how we can improve this without fucking it up.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think you can do 4 seconds better for sure.
Yeah.
Maybe more, depends how aggressive you're going to go, but 4 seconds you should be able to.
Yeah.
Okay? So wait. Whenever you're ready. Take your time if you want.
I'm going to just maybe 1,000 and just slowly let the clutch go.
Questions, any thoughts, any...
I feel like I made up a lot of the time under the braking there,
yeah,
and in the mud, even despite the pylon. The pylon was almost like a sacrifice because I wanted to be on the clear side of the track, where the pylon, nobody had run over the area there, so I knew there wasn't as much mud there.
Yeah.
I feel like I made up a lot more time there.
Good. Yeah, you just need more time, practice, whatever,
yeah,
get used to cars, but yeah, pretty good. And yes, stock suspension is okay for a lot. I mean, it's gonna wear, you're gonna replace it eventually, it's not,
yeah,
like driving on the highway, but... Okay. And a violence. Try to use the mirror like adjuster, you know, switch it to the right mirror. You're like, see? see how it works.